Hello everybody, welcome to the algorithm course. Today I'm going to walk through bubble sort for you. So bubble sort involves these four steps. First, I would like to compare the two adjacent elements in a certain moving window. If the element on the right hand side of the moving window is smaller than the element on the left hand side of the moving window, I would simply swap the two elements. So in the third step, I would like to lengthen the sorted list, and I would also shorten the unsorted list. And for the final step, I would simply repeat all three steps until only one element is left in the unsorted list. Let us see an example. Suppose I have these five numbers, all of which are unsorted. Now I have a moving window, and I would start with the first two elements. I would like to compare them and see if the element on the right-hand side is smaller than the element of the left-hand side. If it is the case, I need to swap the two numbers. So we can see that I need to swap the elements containing 3 and 1. Okay, the two numbers are swapped so that the element on the right-hand side is larger than or equal to the element on the left-hand side of the moving window. After the comparison, I would like to move my moving window to the other two adjacent elements. So I would like to compare them. And for this situation, the element on the right-hand side of the moving window is larger than or equal to the element on the left-hand side of the moving window. So no swap is needed. Then I move my window to the next two adjacent elements, and I would like to compare the values of the two elements. Now, the element on the right-hand side of the moving window is smaller than the element on the left-hand side of the moving window, so I need to swap the two numbers. Okay, now the two numbers are swapped, so that the element on the right-hand side of the moving window is larger than or equal to that of on the left-hand side of the moving window. Okay, I move my window to another two adjacent elements, so I compare them. For now, the situation is like this. The element on the right-hand side is smaller than the element on the left-hand side, so I need to swap the two numbers. Okay, now the two numbers are swapped, so that the element on the right-hand side is larger than or equal to the element on the left-hand side of the moving window. And we can see that the moving window already touches the end of the unsorted list. So in this case, we can end one pass of the sorting. Okay, we can see from the diagram that the largest element in the unsorted list is already moved to the far right of the whole list. So that number becomes sorted, and I have four unsorted numbers remaining in the unsorted list. And the forthcoming process is going to handle the order of the elements in the unsorted list. I would simply keep the sorted one untouched. Okay, I would start with the first two elements in the unsorted list. I would like to compare them. For now, the element on the right-hand side is larger than or equal to the element on the left-hand side of the moving window, so no swap is needed. Then I move my window to the other two adjacent elements. Now, I don't need to swap the two numbers because they still follow the rule that the element on the right-hand side is larger than or equal to the element on the left-hand side. Then I move my window to the next two adjacent elements. And to compare them, we can see that the element on the right-hand side is smaller than the element on the left-hand side. So I need to swap the two numbers. Okay, the two numbers are now swapped, such that the element on the right-hand side is larger than or equal to the element on the left-hand side. We can also see that the moving window has already touched the end of the unsorted list, indicated by the pink arrow. Okay, so for this situation, we can say that we have made another pass of the sorting. Now, the largest element in the unsorted list is already moved to the far right-hand side, so it becomes sorted. So we can see that numbers 4 and 5 are already sorted. So I would like to put them on the far right to become the sorted part. Now we can see that numbers 4 and 5 are already on the sorted part of the list, and the remaining process is going to handle the unsorted numbers in the unsorted list. Okay, I would start with the two elements on the far left hand side of the unsorted list. I would like to compare them, and I can see that the elements on the right hand side is larger than or equal to the element on the left hand side, so no swap is needed. I move the window to the next two adjacent elements. I can see that I need to swap them because the element on the right hand side is smaller than the element on the left hand side. So the two numbers are swapped, so that the element on the right hand side is larger than or equal to the element on the left hand side. Now we can also see that the moving window already touches the end of the unsorted list, indicated by the pink arrow. Now, the largest element in the unsorted list is already moved to the far right, which is referring to the element with number 3, okay. So the element with number 3 is already sorted, so I would put that number to the sorted list component, and I will have two numbers being unsorted yet. Now I move my window to the two numbers in the unsorted list. I would like to compare them to see if swapping is needed. So now the element on the right hand side is larger than or equal to the element on the left hand side, so no swap is needed. And at this stage, we can also see that the moving window already touches the end of the unsorted list, because the moving window has a width of 2 and unsorted list is also having a width of 2. So in this case, I can put the largest element in the unsorted list, which is element with number 2, to the very beginning of the sorted list. So the element with number 2 is already sorted. And now, only one unsorted element remains in the unsorted list component. So we can be sure that all other elements are already sorted. So now the sorting process is complete. Thank you for walking through the algorithm with me. If you have any questions about the video, please leave your questions in the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.